And now we're going to set up and prepare for Vonda's first transaction. The first transaction that Vonda will record is an invoice. When you record an invoice, the results in QuickBooks Online will immediately affect the chart of accounts. The chart of accounts is the general ledger, so whatever items you put on the invoice will affect the accounts in the general ledger, and as soon as you save the invoice, the results will immediately be shown on the main report that shows the result of the general ledger. In this course, after we make transactions, we check the results in the trial balance. The trial balance is the main report for the general ledger, and it shows the current balance of every account in the chart of accounts. Let's go ahead and set up the trial balance to be ready for Vonda's first transaction. When you're here in QuickBooks Online, you should go to the left panel and click Reports. Now, we have to find the trial balance and then put it in a place that is easily accessible for us to open it up quickly. So, the way to do that is to click All Reports, and then the category of reports for the trial balance is Accountant Reports. Notice the trial balance is on the top right of all of the accountant reports in QuickBooks Online. Let's click the word trial balance, and here we are. Now you're getting some nice help information, but we didn't ask for that. So if you get this little pop-up, just close it out. Now of course, the trial balance is blank because we have not yet recorded any transactions. But notice, it opens as of the date that I am recording the video. I'm recording this video on August 15th of 2017. But that's not the dates that I want to see. The dates of the transactions we will record for Vonda are back in January. The best way to prepare this report before we record transactions is to go to the top left and click the pull-down menu and choose All Dates. This way, we can see the results of all transactions regardless of date. Now we have to save this change so that we can easily come back to it and we won't have to change it every time we have a transaction. The way to save the changes in a report is to go to the top right and click Save Customization. Then it asks you to put a particular name, and we can leave the name Trial Balance. Then we click Save. Now, of course, we will have a separate video very soon regarding customizing and saving reports. But for now, all you need to know is that if you alter a report and you want to keep the alterations, you click Save, and then that report will be shown here, Reports, and then you click My Custom Reports. And so far, the only one that you customized is the trial balance. So after we set up a report and we need to find it, it's much more convenient to click My Custom Reports and have it listed here with the ones that you use. Now, the general ledger is not the only area of data that will change when you record an invoice. When you record an invoice, it means that a customer owes you money, and you therefore have to keep customer records of who owes you money for how and when and why. The name of the report that shows the specific customers that owe you for open invoice is called the customer balance detail. And we're going to set that one up and put that one in our report area so we can easily access that report after we record our transactions. Here we are back in QuickBooks Online. We're going to click Reports, then click All Reports, and the reports that we want to click for the customer records are here, Manage Account Receivable. Now when we click on it, the top right shows the most important customer report, the customer balance detail. Let's click to open it up, and of course, you can see that it's empty because we have not recorded any transactions yet. This one conveniently says all dates already, so we don't have to change anything. But because we want to save it in the custom report area so that it is convenient to go back to, we will still click Save Customization, leave the name, and click Save. Now that we saved it, we can click Reports. And for the rest of this course, we'll go back to My Custom Reports, and you can see that this is on the list of custom reports so that it's much easier to find and much quicker to get to after we record a transaction. Now here's Vonda's first transaction. January 1, did 10 video hours for Alan on account. On account means Alan only promised to pay at the moment he received the service, and therefore the proper document to make is an invoice. Now, in a moment, we're going to put in the invoice every piece step by step. But before we do that, let's think about this transaction for a moment. I happen to know that the total amount of this invoice is going to be $3,000 because it's 10 video hours, and we set up the video item to be $300 an hour. Then the question is, after we record the invoice, what will show as the result in the trial balance? Well, if we earned video income for $3,000, that means after we record the invoice, video income will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $3,000. It also means that some customer somewhere owes you $3,000, and the account in the chart of accounts that represents the total money that all customers owe us together is accounts receivable. So after we record this invoice, you will see the trial balance will show $3,000 for accounts receivable and $3,000 for video income. You should also know that the customer balance detail will list each individual customer's balance. Right now it's blank, but if specifically Alan owes us $3,000 for this invoice, that means our customer records will reflect that Alan RB owes us $3,000 after we record this invoice. To open the invoice window in QuickBooks Online, we click Sales, and then we click Invoice. Now, again, because this is the very first invoice, we will get this green button with a picture. After we save our invoice, when we come back, we will not see this. Send your first invoice, and here's the window. So, we're going to put the date. You know, they give you a little tutorial, but we're going to click No Thanks because this video is a tutorial. And to get the invoice date, click right in the calendar. Then you have to click the back button to go back to the month that the invoice actually happened. In this case, we go back to January and click January 1. We'll talk about the due date in a future video. The particular customer in this case is Alan. In the top left, that's where you choose a customer. When you click the arrow, you notice these are the three customers that we put on our customer list in a previous video. And when we click on the specific customer, you'll notice the address that we set up in that previous video automatically comes into this field. Now, not only are the customers on the list, but the products or services are already on the items list. Click directly under the words product or service to get the pull-down arrow. Click on the arrow and you can see here are the two services that we put and the other two that QuickBooks Online put. In this case, we click video and notice QuickBooks remembered that's $300 an hour. All we have to do is change the quantity to the quantity in the transaction. Now, listen carefully. If you want to save only one little field of information without leaving the whole window, go to the left of your keyboard and push the Tab key. When I push Tab, QuickBooks saves the field and then multiplies the quantity times the rate that we set up to give you the amount of the invoice, $3,000. So if you need to pause the video to make all of your fields of information the same as mine, you can go ahead and pause before you click save. I'm going to click save, and now we get to close the invoice. Now that it confirms that this is saved, I'm going to close the invoice window, and now I'm going to check the results in the reports. Reports, my custom reports, here's the trial balance. When we click on the trial balance, aha, we see the numbers are exactly as I predicted before we recorded the invoice. Video income is 3,000 and accounts receivable is 3,000. Remember, the general ledger is not the only place that shows the results of transactions. If we click reports and go back to my custom reports, we can check the customer balance detail by clicking on it, and you can see that specifically Alan Arby owes us $3,000. Now, after you record Vonda's second transaction, you will see all the ideas come together. Let's imagine on January 2nd, we did 10 editing hours for customer Betty. And again, it's on account, which means Betty only promised to pay at the moment she received the service, and the appropriate document is an invoice. Well, I happen to know that the amount of that invoice will be $1,400, because I remember when we set up the editing item, it was $140 an hour, and if it's 10 hours, it'll be $1,400. So what will be the results in the trial balance after we record the second invoice? Well, editing income will show up for the very first time as $1,400, because this is the first time we recorded editing income. However, since an additional customer owes us more money from another service, accounts receivable will increase by the amount owed and become $4,400. And if you want to know why is accounts receivable $4,400, well, accounts receivable represents the total money that all customers together owe us. And that will be clarified in the customer balance detail. When we record this second invoice for customer Betty, our customer records will reflect the fact that specifically Betty Boop owes us $1,400. And if we remember that Alan owes us $3,000, that means the total money that all customers owe us together is $4,400, and that explains why accounts receivable in the trial balance will be $4,400 after we record this invoice. The other way to open the invoice window is to go to the top right and click the plus sign, then go all the way to the left in the column of customers and click the top choice, invoice. This is the same invoice window we were at a moment ago. Now, to put in the date, click where it says invoice date in the right side of the date box. You'll see the little calendar symbol, click once. When the date box shows up, click the back arrow and go all the way back to January. Then click on January 2. Now don't worry about the due date. We'll discuss that in a future video. To choose the customer, move the mouse to the top left, click the pull down arrow, and this time we choose Betty Boop. Notice when we click on Betty, the name and address that we set up in the previous video shows up here in this field. Click directly under the words product/service to bring the arrow that gives us the item choice. Then we click on the arrow and we choose the item on this invoice, which is editing. Notice when we click on editing to choose it, QuickBooks remembers that editing is $140 an hour because that's what we set up in the previous video when we made our items list. Click inside the quantity field and type 10. Now remember, to save just the little field without leaving the whole window, go to the left of your keyboard and push tab. When I push tab, it saves the field, and QuickBooks multiplies the quantity of 10 times the rate of 140 and shows us the amount of this invoice is 1,400. Now we finish the second invoice. When we click save, we can check the results in the trial balance to see if they are exactly what we expected. We close the invoice window, go back to reports. Hopefully my custom reports is already selected. And when you double click on the trial balance, you see the numbers are exactly what we predicted. Editing income shows up for the first time as 1,400 and total accounts receivable equals 4,400 after the second invoice. If you want to know why total accounts receivable is 4,400, you can open the other report, the customer balance detail. Click to the left where it says reports. Hopefully it will remember that you like to go to my custom reports, and just double click on customer balance detail. Now you can see just only Alan owes us 3,000. Specifically, Betty Boop owes us 1,400, and that explains why total accounts receivable and the trial balance is equal to the total at the bottom of this report, $4,400.